Am I the a-hole for not inviting my brother to my wedding and telling my parents and sister that if they try to bring him, they will all be asked to leave? I have an older sister and a younger brother. Growing up, I was close to both my sister and brother. Then around high school, my brother started flirting with the girls I liked, even girls I was dating. Ended up in a relationship with one of my exes right after we broke up. And then he ended up sleeping with my ex-fiancée while we were together and 3 months away from our wedding. After that, I cut him off. I said we were done. He was dead to me and I no longer had a brother and never would again. It's been 7 years and I'm engaged again. My wedding is actually this January. It's small, intimate, with our closest friends and family. But my parents and sister are upset that my brother didn't get an invite. But I told them he was not welcome. They said he's still my brother, and I said no, he stopped being my brother a long time ago. He reached out via social media and asked if we could let the past be the past and move on. That he had always regretted what he did. He knows he treated me horribly, but he has changed so much throughout his 20s and wants to make amends. I blocked him and didn't reply. Then my sister said she would just bring him as her plus one if I won't be the bigger man. So I told her and my parents, they were there during this, that if any of them bring him with them, I will make sure they all leave and they will not be welcomed back to the wedding, and that I'm serious about this. They are saying I'm an a-hole, and that if I'm happy, I should be open to reconciling. Am I the a-hole? Now for the top comments. Not the a-hole. Yes, people grow and change, but the harm is done. You can't do it. Plus, it's your day. Do what makes you happy. I will say consider reconciliation in the future when you're not pressured into it. You might be able to foster a level of civility. He should cut them all out of his life. The family's on good terms with a crappy person, which makes them crappy. Not they all at all, but I think it's extreme to cut them all off for actions that weren't theirs. Parents won't just never talk to Opie's brother. He's their son, albeit an a-hole one. It's not Opie's place to dictate the parents-brother relationship. In the same way, it's not the family's place to dictate Opie's, lack of, relationship with a brother. Opie did all the right things, and shouldn't be pressured into reconciliation. If they choose to ignore his reasonable boundaries, then maybe it is time to consider cutting them all off his life. Not day home. You're not obligated to reconcile within someone else's time frame. The fact that your sister believes he would choose to come if she asked him as her plus one would seem to indicate he might not have changed all that much. Also, that's some nerve on her part. The wedding isn't about your parents, your sister, or your brother. It's about you and your fiancé. This. He is forcing himself back into Opie's life as if he is entitled to be there. His behavior gives me the feeling as if he thinks more about how he will look like towards others if he isn't invited to his brother's wedding. Not day home. Info. Did he actually say, I'm sorry to you? Did he describe how he would treat you differently if you let him back into your life? He did say he was sorry, and I'm not sure if he said what he would do differently. I didn't really read the whole thing. It was long AF, and I was not interested. Next story is titled, Am I the A-hole for telling my brother he downgraded? My 28 female brother Mike, 33 male, was married to Lisa, 31 female, for 4 years. Until last year when he was caught cheating with Penny, 29 female. My ex-sister-in-law was reserved, sweet and was straight edge, no alcohol slash drugs. Mike loves to party and went to court-ordered rehab before he was even 21. When Mike met Lisa, he sobered up, got an apprenticeship and really turned his life around. He also threw that all away on Penny. Penny knew he was married, she got him drunk and that is how the affair started. Penny is loud, disgusting, obnoxious, and encourages my brother to drink. He thinks she's just so fun and the life of the party. We were at a family party this past weekend, and Mike and Penny were there. Some cousins we hadn't seen in years were there too and were introduced to Penny. And Mike introduced her as his upgrade. Cue major side eye for me. My brother noticed and pulled me aside later. He asked then why the attitude, that Penny was clearly an upgrade. He asked him to explain that comment. But he said that she's blonde, curvy, and fun, whereas Lisa looked like a librarian with no front. I decided to clear things up for him. Penny is obnoxious, rude, slovenly. Her hair is poorly bleached, and she smells like fungus. No one looks at her like a prize to be won. No one is jealous of him, which he thinks they are. His best friend won't even talk to him anymore because Penny made a dead baby joke to his wife after a miscarriage. I let him know that he actually chose alcohol over his ex. and Penny just encouraged him to do it because she had a crush on him for years. He called me a witch, and I told him same scenes. Pretty sure I am the a-hole on this one, to be honest. Not the a-hole. Your brother picked someone who makes dead baby jokes to his best friend after a trauma, costing him the friendship. That's not an upgrade. While I do agree with everything you say, I don't know, for some reason, something about calling a human an upgrade versus downgrade just doesn't sit well with me. It almost feels like you value them less as a person, which I think is incorrect. Everyone sucks here, in my opinion. Not today, home. Sounds like Penny's a downgrade, but it's the grade that Mike deserves. In business, they call it right-sizing. You're the a-hole for attacking her. Your brother is the one who cheated. His choice, his responsibility, not hers. Yeah, I agree. The looks were a low blow. Sleeping with a married man knowingly makes her a home wrecker. She didn't say the vows, but she helped into cheating. It takes two to tango, and no cheater waltz by themselves. Next story. Am I the a-hole for making my ex-husband's pregnant wife cry? So, my both 29 ex cheated on me with Rose, 30. She knew he had a wife and three kids because she was both my maid of honor and cousin. It's no shock that she doesn't like the fact she has to share my ex's attention with his three kids, 9 female, 4 male, and 3 male. It limits how much time we speak, aka co-parenting. So when she announced her pregnancy a few months ago, it was honestly the countdown before my kids were pushed aside. Like, obviously, she isn't all to blame as their father should put them first. Since she's pissed on that stick, there's been multiple weeks where she was too ill to have the children stay, or they had to come home early. Then she's miraculously is well enough to go out to dinner or see a movie. They come to me a few weeks ago, and suggested that basically 2 weeks before her due date and until the baby is 2 weeks old, that my ex wouldn't take them but FaceTime and visit every day, minus when she goes into labor plus a few days after. Which was fair, and I agreed. Till tonight. I got a phone call from my crying 9-year-old. Apparently, my cousin brought herself McDonald's back for dinner, and when my 3-year-old asked for a chicken nuggets, she screamed at him, calling him a fat pig, then went on a rant on how much she hated having them over because they make her sick. By the time I got there, their POS father was waiting outside with my very upset kids. I asked my sister to get them into the car and pull down a little bit so they wouldn't hear anything. Before I could talk, he blamed it on her hormones and tried to laugh it off. But I told him he was a crappy father and a coward. Then cousin waddled up to the door and suggested that the kids don't come back till the baby's at least 5 months old. She's 6 months pregnant, by the way. And no FaceTime or visits when she turns 8 months until the baby is 3 months old, so they have a chance to bond. I stared at her till she tried to blame it on her bleeding and breastfeeding. Had enough. So I said, they're kids, not sharks. So the bleeding BS wouldn't work, wicked stepmom. We have been trying to push my kids out since day one. But guess what? You can have him completely like a man that throws away his kids for some no good woman. And I don't want my boys to think that's how to act. And I don't want you around my daughter for the same reason I pity your kid. She started crying and my ex called me cold-hearted witch. I said thanks, then walked away. After all the phone calls and calming down, I think I went into a-hole mode. Now for the top comments before the little update. I'm going to say not today, home. She clearly wants to start over with her husband and exclude the kids. Shame on your husband for not sticking up for his own kids. Yeah, that's the worst part. He should have stuck up for his kids long ago. I think he's way more at fault than the current wife. Truthfully, yes, you're right. I know I hate her, but he has full blame because if I was dating a guy and he didn't treat my kids like his own, we wouldn't be together. Not stay home, Mama Bear. I think you should give your ex's wife what she wants and try to get full custody of the kids. Oh, I am, don't worry about that. No dad is better than a crappy one. Not stay home. I feel so bad for your kids. Your ex is the a-hole for letting someone kick his kids out of his life. They won't forget how horrible him and his wife have treated them. It may be best for you to keep them away. My daughter cried herself to sleep asking why her father didn't want her. I feel horrible because this has caused drama with my ex-in-laws too. So it's obviously gotta hurt her more. Edit. To the people sending me messages offering me money to help pay for a lawyer, even though you're amazing people with good hearts, it's not a money issue. I've not gone full custody yet because, and this is the most heartbreaking reason, my kids love their father so much. My ex is my 9-year-old daughter's world. Her face lights up when he drops by, and she's smiling the whole day. but unfortunately she cries herself to sleep when they cut the visit short. So for months, I fought with myself about going full custody. Next story. Am I the a-hole for leaving early for my husband's party? I, 28 male, and my husband, 30 male, are newlyweds. We got married this August and had a very small wedding. We just bought a wonderful townhouse that is great for us and our two dogs. We both work full-time and split the bills. All of the families get along very well, and we couldn't be happier. The only issue that we have is that his friend group likes to make jokes and pull pranks on people. They post all of their videos on social media and will pull pranks on people that aren't expecting them. I have voiced my concern with my husband, and he will tell them to tone it down. But when my husband hangs with them, his personality will change. My sister, 25 female, had a birthday party this past June, and they decided to squirt invisible ink all over her dress. She was devastated, and I spent the rest of the night fighting with my husband. His reaction is always the same. It's just me having fun with the boys. We celebrated his birthday on Monday and had his party at his parents' house. I went over earlier to help set up and baked my husband's favorite dessert, Dutch apple pie. I put some whipped cream on the pie and placed it in the fridge. The party seemed to be going great until I saw one of his friends carrying the pie I made and slams it into my husband's face, wishing him a happy birthday. Husband was laughing and went to clean himself off. I was shocked and speechless. I said goodbye to his family and left. When husband came home, he was pissed that I left and told me to take a joke. I have been giving him the cold shoulder since. Am I the a-hole for leaving early for my husband's birthday party? Not the a-hole. A reminder that if everyone isn't laughing, it's not a joke. It's cruelty. Plain and simple. Your husband and his friends need to grow up. Nobody else was laughing except him and his friends. They destroyed your work. If you weren't laughing, then it wasn't a joke. Why is he okay with your work and effort for his birthday being destroyed as a joke? Not a hole. His friends clearly don't care how their actions affect others. Your husband is completely disregarding your feelings, and wasting the dessert you made especially for him was disrespectful. If he wants to interact with his buddies like this, he needs to do so away from your family and any other innocent bystanders. While his friends may consent to pranking each other, the other victims clearly did not. Not stay home. He spent time and effort baking his favorite dessert. What happens if other people wanted some and it's not available because his friend did that? It's one thing to bring a separate pie to do that with, but they destroyed something you did for him. Can't have fun with the boys without being a nuisance to people around you, which sounds like they are. Your sister definitely didn't ask to be part of their pranks. She did not want to be part of any of the pranks. She had no idea it was invisible ink until they told her. Now for the last story. Am I the a-hole for leaving my sister's wedding with my husband after he got kicked out of it? My female 30, sister's female 27 wedding was last week. She and her husband chose formal attire as the dress code for their wedding. It was mentioned beforehand to give guests the heads up. But when my husband, male 33, found out, he didn't like it. He didn't like it at all, saying he didn't think it was fair to dictate what guests wear in the first place, and that this entire rule was stupid and unnecessary. Then complained in person to my sister and her now husband. He said he wanted to wear something casual, which is what he usually wear, and asked if they could turn a blind eye and just let him attend wearing casual since his family. My brother-in-law said rules are for all with no exceptions. My husband repeatedly expressed how uncomfortable he was wearing a suit, and that all of his old suits are just lame and made him look older. My brother-in-law stated this was the official dress code and asked my husband to either follow it or not go. My husband came home after that, saying my brother-in-law was power-tripping and acting like a typical spoiled white kid who wants everything his way and control others as they were puppets. I said that it's his wedding, so of course he gets the final say, and suggested that he wear his newest suit and buy a tie. At the day of the wedding, I went early to help my sister since I had a part in it, and then suddenly we heard noise coming from the entrance. It was my husband, wearing blue jeans and a red Gera t-shirt, arguing with my brother-in-law and the staff, insisting on getting inside. I rushed to get involved, and my brother-in-law repeatedly asked my husband to go put on a suit or not come back. My husband refused, and they exchanged a few choice words and mom got involved, but my brother-in-law told him to leave. My husband resisted, then told me to grab my stuff so we could leave together. But I said no. He looked stunned, but I said I didn't do anything. Besides, I wanted to be with my sister and had work to do. He got upset and left. He blew up at me after I got home, saying I had no problem standing there watching my sister and her husband humiliate and kick him out, then refusing to take a stand and leave with him. I told him this was the outcome of his stubbornness, and he replied saying, since when wanting to have a freedom to wear whatever I want meant stubbornness? He said I should have supported him and went home with him, and not let my family mistreat him like that. Not a day home. Your husband had plenty of notice to find something appropriate to wear, was repeatedly told a dress code, and yet he turned up in jeans and a t-shirt. He didn't even attempt to dress nice casual in slacks and a button-up. He's definitely the a-hole in this situation. You support your spouse when they're in the right, not when they're behaving like toddlers that don't want to wear their socks. The husband is an extra a-hole for his typical white spoiled kid comment, just because he didn't get what he wanted. Dress codes are normal for wedding, work, but he wants to be the big exception. In Germany, we call it extravost. Whining about freedom and acting like a dress code is oppression? Sounds like a typical white spoiled kid to me. Not a day home. You didn't humiliate him. He humiliated himself. He was repeatedly told the rules and if he couldn't follow them, he shouldn't show up. Hopefully when he comes down, he can be the better person and apologize. If he can't, good luck navigating that. But do not waste a minute thinking you and your family are to blame over his hurt feelings or embarrassment. Not a day home. Your husband sounds like an entitled prick. No idea why I married him. Totally agree. His freedom is more important than anyone else's wishes. Like he is the most important person anywhere. That makes him a baby and a huge a-hole and certainly not ready for marriage. Not a day, OP. But how do you stand him?